Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. I've been testing iOS 18 on my iPhone here for some weeks now, and I've come up with a list of 16 important settings you want to set up and change right away once you've upgraded to iOS 18. Besides the new Apple Intelligence stuff, this is a big update and there are plenty of incredible features that will breathe fresh air and new functionality into your iPhone. The very first setting to switch on is the new charging limit feature, which will help preserve and extend the life of your iPhone. To turn on this new feature, go into settings and then into battery, and then underneath battery, go click into charging. And then from here, you can see that there's a new charge limit slider right here. So I recommend sliding this down to 90% because this gives you almost the entire battery capacity while still preserving battery health. If you don't have this feature, you can always just activate the optimized battery charging setting right here to cap it at an 80% charge. The next one is one iPhone users have been waiting a long time for, which is rich communication services. Enabling RCS will allow iPhones more texting support and features when messaging our Android friends, like read receipts, set up custom group chats, and even sending higher quality photos and videos, just like iMessage. To enable this, just go into settings, then scroll all the way down to apps, and then just go ahead and type in messages and find messages, click into this. So under messages, if your provider supports it, you can now turn on RCS messaging, switch this on, and it should look like something like this. And with it enabled, your iPhone will finally play nice with Android phones. Speaking of messaging, we can now finally schedule text messages and even format them. So going to messages here, when you send a new message like hello, click on the plus icon on the left-hand side and then scroll down to send later. So in here, you can literally send it within the next few hours or even the next few days. So let's schedule this at a random time here. Then go ahead and click send. And as you can see, we've now scheduled the message and this draft message will send at that selected time. You can now even format your texts if you want. So clicking onto this icon right here, you can bold, you can underline, and then you can send. And there we go. We have a formatted text message now. Another big change is the integrated passwords manager. That's definitely worth setting up. So going into settings again and scrolling down to apps, find the passwords app. So I'll just search for it. This one here, passwords. From here, just make sure that these three toggles are switched on and these will ensure strong passwords will be auto-created. Then come back out to the home screen and find the new passwords app. It'll look like this. Tap into it. And here, this app will generate strong passwords that will autofill when you're on a website or an app. And you can even tap the left icon right here, and this will share logins and passwords with groups without actually revealing the password itself. There are plenty of password managers out there, but it's great to finally see a comprehensive password manager that's natively built into iOS 18. While we're talking about security, the new privacy and security panel on iPhones has transformed. So go back into settings, then scroll down to privacy and security right here. And as you can see, this is a new format. It's also worth taking a look over this page to see what your iPhone is tracking and to turn off unnecessary access. And after you've done that, let's move on to some must change privacy and security settings. So there is a new contacts privacy feature in iOS 18. I highly recommend that you take a look through this. So in here, scroll down and then click contacts right here. And now you can see all the apps that have access to your contacts. And there's finally the ability to limit which contacts an app can see by just tapping into one of these and limiting the access. It's really important that you actually take a moment to review this because before iOS 18, you only had two options. When an app wanted access to your contacts, you either let them access all the contacts in your address book or none at all. It's worth spending a few minutes reviewing app access to your contacts and customizing the access to what you feel comfortable with. Now, in the same privacy settings, here's something you should definitely turn off. I always recommend this, and this is system location usage. So tap into location services, then scroll all the way down into system services down here, and then all the way down again in significant locations. And then from here, just toggle this off. If you haven't toggled it off, you can usually see where the locations that your iPhone has been tracking you with. So you want to go ahead and clear the history as well if it's been keeping tabs on you. But don't worry, this won't turn off location services that some apps need, like the Maps app. But instead, it removes the log of your every movement, which is pretty invasive and also eats into battery life and cellular data. Okay, moving on to a new clutch feature. It's called Motion Cues, and this is designed to prevent motion sickness when you're using your iPhone in a car. So go into Settings and then scroll down to Accessibility, then tap into Motion, and there's a new option called Show Vehicle Motion Cues. Tap into this. And then when it's switched on, as you can see, you get these little dots here. And what this does is it plays visual trickery on your brain to offset the vehicle motion to help prevent car sickness. I like to set this to automatic so the inbuilt gyro detects when you're moving in a car, but it's also worth adding a shortcut to the new controls gallery. So now when you swipe down on the top right, you get this new redesigned controls gallery, and there's a lot more going on here and gives you, well, a lot more control. So tap the plus button up here, and so you can see that there's plenty of new spots here where you can customize and add a bunch of controls into. So let's click add control at the bottom. And from here, there are just so many different new controls we can add into our control gallery. And to give you an example, let's tap search and type in motion cues. And you can see here, vehicle motion cues. I'll just drop this in here. And now we can just shift it into a spot that we want. And we've got a new shortcut to the motions cue. Moving out to the lock screen, in iOS 18, we can now customize the lock screen by just holding down the screen and then clicking customize here, and then tap the lock screen. And then there's now two bubbles to add shortcuts here. Traditionally, the bottom right button brings up the camera, but we can now switch it to whatever we like now. So to give you an example, I work remotely a lot, so I want to set up a Wi-Fi hotspot shortcut right here. So I'll remove the current shortcut, tap plus, and then search for hotspot. So just type in hotspot, personal hotspot, and right there, I've set up a Wi-Fi hotspot shortcut. And by the way, if you like this wallpaper, I'll leave a link to it below. Moving on, the next setting you have to change is vocal shortcuts. Setting this up will create convenient shortcuts with your voice that even Siri can't do. So go into settings again, and then scroll down to accessibility, then all the way down to vocal shortcuts right here, and then switch this on. So from here, just click add action and then select the custom shortcut that you want to activate. So let's just say mute and then name it mute, click go, and then just say mute three times. Mute, mute, mute. Then if you say any of these shortcuts, it'll activate automatically. A great one, for example, I've set up is to take a photo if I just say snap photo, which is quite useful if I've got the iPhone away from me and I just want to set up as a tripod and I just say snap photo. And you can see right here, it's activated my voice snap photo function and it's taken a photo, which is quite useful when I want to snap a selfie or something like that. And it's perfect for those solo travel trips where I can just snap a photo of myself with my voice. Next, Keep Downloaded is a new feature in iOS 18 where you can now select files that stay on your phone locally and also on iCloud. This way, if you don't have an internet connection, you can still have access to that file. To do this, go into the Files app and then choose the file that you want to store locally, then long press the file. And you can now see that we've got a new Keep Downloaded option. Just click into that and then it will save this locally for offline access. This is a great new feature to set up, especially if you travel a lot. Now Apple just needs to bring this functionality to photos. Now the Safari browser has got a pretty useful new feature. It's called Highlights and it's definitely worth turning on. So in settings, go into apps all the way at the bottom and then search for Safari. Then scroll all the way down to Highlights and make sure this is toggled on because this was off when I first installed iOS 18. Now, when I'm browsing a web page, highlights will pop up with useful highlights, like more info about the movie, song, or point of location. For some reason, during testing, it popped up twice, but I'm not able to get it back up to show you right now, but turn it on and definitely give it a go. So next up is game mode, and this is a game changer for those who game on their iPhone. So once you launch a game, gaming mode should turn on automatically, but if it doesn't, pull down on the top right, and then select the top, game mode, and from here, you can now toggle on and off game mode, and it's actually quite useful. It reduces background activity across all the apps to boost gaming performance, and it even reduces audio latency and Bluetooth controller responsiveness by doubling the Bluetooth polling rate in this mode. Just a heads up though, that this will drain battery slightly faster, so if you're tight on battery life, it's worth turning gaming mode off. Now, in the Maps app, this is something worth setting up or at least checking out, and it's the new walking trails function. So going into Maps, and let's say we're at Central Park in New York City, and here you can just long press anywhere in the park, like for example, right here, and then click the More button, and then click this new Create a Custom Route button. This is a really cool feature where you can now long press any other points in the map, like up here in Central Park, and then you can see the trail's length, the elevation, and estimated time to walk it. You can even close the loop or reverse and see the different stats and even save the trails for later. Okay, then of course, there's the new home screen customization options. Long press anywhere on the home screen and tap edit and click the new customize option. So this is pretty cool. Here we finally get what Android users have had for years now, full app and home screen customizability. It's worth playing around with it to get it just the way you like it. And I can't wait to see what others come up with. So there's a whole bunch of different options here. You can tint the colors, you can go into light mode, you can go back into dark mode. You can literally change the color of the app icons simply by adding that tint. And yeah, there's a lot of customizability options now. And you can even now lock and hide apps behind Face ID by long pressing the app and then tapping require Face ID if, you know, you wanna hide apps from people that have access to your phone, I guess. Now, if you made it to the very end of this video, drop the code word comment iPhone OS and I'll give it a like. If you found this video useful, drop a like, subscribe for more. And if you have a MacBook, I'll share a video here somewhere with the must change settings to get the most out of your Mac. As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.